It's time then for the Mexico City Grand Prix, a race which gave Honda their first ever victory back in 1965. American Richie Ginther winning from third on the grid. Red Bull have been strong here in recent seasons, but can they keep that record going today? We're a long way above sea level here in Mexico today, which could pose some cooling issues for the cars as they make their way around this 2.6-mile lap. 17 corners with top speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, and watch out for potential overtaking into turns 1 and 4. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Midas lines up on pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Vettel, George Russell, and Fernando Alonso. Ricciardo, Norris, Bottas, and Lewis Hamilton. Mick Schumacher, Ocon, Sergio Perez, and Oscar Piastri. Magnussen, Latifi, Pierre Gasly, and Alex Albon. Joe, Stroll, Tsunoda, and Nico Hülkenberg rounds off the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Clutch bright is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. overtake button and see what you can do. Try to keep focus. by 18.6 seconds. burn off some of this energy. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. That was our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops, let's go. We'll be right back. leave your teammate behind is 29.9 seconds. of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Taking through the yellow flags. us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left.
Today then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had. Congratulations to the whole team. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, I certainly didn't have any complaints with Nico Hülkenberg's performance today. That was incredible driving.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago.